Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Monday, October 12th, 2009. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the things we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback on this video. Now, whether you're watching this video on YouTube or on FX Bootcamp's Facebook page or possibly from a link on FX Bootcamp's Twitter page or even on the FX Bootcamp blog, please leave a comment when you're done watching. Even if you just say hi or thanks, that would be very much appreciated. Now, I'd like to clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer Bootcamp members are trading on a demo account, so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade in their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. What you now see is a view showing two charts for the EURUSD currency pair as they looked at 9:30 a.m. New York time on GFT's DealBook 360 trading platform using FX Bootcamp's custom layout. On the left is a 15-minute chart and on the right is an hourly chart with daily pivot points and Fibonacci extensions of Friday's range. Now, I've got this 15-minute chart zoomed out to show most of the price action from last Friday, where I see a swing high near the 1.4770 level. Now, that, along with some price action from last Thursday, which I don't show in this view, suggests potential resistance at that 1.4770 level. So I had a line drawn there, the horizontal dark gray line that you see on this chart. I had that line drawn there during today's London session. Now, if I zoom in on this 15-minute chart, I now see that the euro has stalled at that level of resistance for the past 2.5 hours after rising earlier. You see the rise here. The euro rise earlier on the back of dollar weakness starting at today's London Open, which was somewhere down in here. Down here is London Open. Now, the fact that the euro has basically stalled for the first 90 minutes of New York trading doesn't really surprise me. During Friday's live sessions at FX Bootcamp, I talked about this day, Monday, having the potential to be sort of, well, ho-hum. Some price action, mostly technical, but probably nothing significant. Likely not a huge or big day for the financial markets. Now, why would I say that? Simply because we've got a boatload of news events with real market moving potential scheduled in the days to come this week. Today is a bank holiday in the U.S. and Canada with no major U.S. news on the calendar. Historically, that suggests the combination of banking holidays, no major news, and a Monday, that suggests a high probability of lower than normal volatility in the currency markets. Tomorrow brings a couple of reports from across the pond that could influence the pound and the euro, but still no U.S. economy-related news on tomorrow. That's Tuesday. Tuesday, the big U.S. news, that comes on Wednesday in a big way. We've got third quarter earnings from Intel after the U.S. stock market closed on Tuesday, which could affect the currency market starting in Wednesday's Asian session, and then starting with the release of third quarter earnings from major U.S. bank JP Morgan before Wednesday's New York session, we've got a major dose of U.S. news running up through Thursday's London close. So, bottom line, I was open to a solid trade setup today, but I was not going to go out of my way to find one today because of the prospect of relatively stalled markets as traders wait for this week's heavy news days. For example, on this EURUSD, if you weren't already long on this pair near, say, the bounce at support at the 4680 level down here at around London Open, you might have taken this bounce. It's a double bottom. It's also a swing low from prior trading days. If you didn't take that shot, you might have been looking for what we call a pullback, in this case, a drop in price to one or more sources of support, such as a Fibonacci retracement level or maybe the 21 AMA on this 15-minute chart. For example, one scenario here, after the earlier rise, would have been a drop during the lunch session to the 21 AMA. A bounce at the 21 EMA at or near the New York Open in the context of the previous uptrend starting at the London Open could have been a viable long trade setup. The idea was just bounce up and break resistance and off we go. Instead, as I just mentioned earlier, the euro goes flat for 90 minutes after the New York session open. Moving forward in time now, 15-minute increments. The euro then breaks resistance at the U.S. equity market open. Now, we generally look for setups with potential to produce 40 to 50 pips in profit, especially on a major currency pair like the EURUSD. But at the top of this latest green candle, we're within just 15 pips of today's M4 pivot point. Now, by my math, if you were perfect on a long trade entry, such as the pullback on this current green 15-minute candle, pullback to the 5 EMA there, unless you're perfect on the entry there and in picking the ultimate top for the day, just above 1.4810, if you're perfect with entry and exit before today's London close represented by the red vertical line, you squeeze maybe 25 pips out of this one. Now, I, for one, don't like having to be perfect just to eke out a couple dozen pips on any currency pair, so not taking that trade at all seemed a viable plan to me. Now, there were other setups on other currency pairs involving a few more pips than that. One example was a 60 pip short on the pound yen, but nothing really added up to what we would consider good trading, really good trading for the New York session. And again, there were clues, especially the news calendar, suggesting that a capital preservation might be the best plan today. My name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Monday, October 12th.